big observation from the Supreme Court of India today, granting Arvind Kejriwal the Delhi Chief Minister. Big relief to Delhi Chief Minister, but the details of this is as follows. He is not going to be walking out of jail immediately today. Supreme Court has granted him bail in connection with the case with the Liquorgate scam. And this is the case, the matter that the Enforcement Directorate was probing. However, remember, the CBI is also looking into this matter. And the Delhi Chief Minister just yet does not have relief in that particular case. However, it is now being looked at in this way that this relief from the Supreme Court of India, with the court also saying that he has suffered for the last 90 days, could be making things easier for the Delhi Chief Minister in connection with the CBI case against him. Srishti Oja is back with us with the very latest on that story. Talk to us about the next legal strategy. How is he going to be moving forward, given this big judgment, really big order from the Supreme Court of India that has also said that he is an elected leader. You can interrogate him. There is no need for custody in that case. Nalini, our legal editor, is also with us. I'm going to go back to Srishti in a moment from now. Nalini, put this into perspective. My sense is that things will be way easier from here on, given the observations from the Supreme Court of India today.
Well, yes, Sneha, it's a big judgment coming in from the Supreme Court, essentially because the Supreme Court has interpreted certain provisions of the PMLA that might essentially make it more difficult for the ED to arrest certain accused in case the larger bench decides so. So they have left it open to the larger bench to interpret as to whether or not there should be certain conditions put in place to necessitate the arrest of a particular person under the PMLA, on the same lines that under Section 45 of the PMLA, there are stringent conditions in place for a person to get bail. So if there are stringent conditions in place for a person to get bail, which makes it difficult for him to get bail, the Supreme Court has said that there should be a look into whether or not there should be similar conditions put on ED in reference to arresting somebody in a particular money laundering case. So it's a very significant judgment. It might change the way the ED functions and the PMLA is interpreted in the future cases to come. And this is something Justice Sanjeev Khanna had said very early on in the hearing, that this entire case that Arvind Kejriwal has filed challenging his arrest might have larger ramifications on the Prevention of Money Laundering Act itself, which will directly lead to ramifications on ED's powers to arrest and also possibly the grant of bail for certain accused. So it's going to be a significant judgment. It has been referred to a larger bench, which means that a constitution bench is going to be possibly looking into this matter. We're still awaiting to see what the details of the judgment are. But some very pertinent observations coming in from the Supreme Court, where the Supreme Court's also spoken about how Kejriwal has suffered for several days. And even though he might not be being released right now in light of this judgment, because he's in custody in the CBI case, but at the same time, there is no doubt about the fact that he will be heaving a huge sigh of relief, even though he's behind bars right now, because it's a very, very favorable judgment that has come in his favor right from the top court of India.
A big relief, you know, and this is not just about one man, but the entire party that he is leading. He's the head of the government in Delhi. Imagine the relief to the workers as well. The cadre of the Aam Aadmi Party, wherein the court has today said that he suffered for 90 days. This, of course, is a big relief for the Delhi CM, even though he's not walking out of jail immediately. Kanu, in fact, was in court. Kanu, give us a sense of what's the way forward. What's the legal road ahead for the Delhi CM here?
Well, the legal questions that are being framed by the Supreme Court is basically on whether what was the need of arrest in such cases, why on the basis of mere interrogation is not the basis of arrest. This is what the Supreme Court has categorically pointed out. They have framed three questions for the larger bench to decide whether in these cases, what was the need of arrest, what is the power of the investigating officer, and what is the power of the court. So everything needs to to be decided by a larger bench, which will be a constitutional bench of five judges, who will now decide that as to as in all the ED cases, what happens and when, what was the need of arrest? Because in this particular case, Arvind Kejriwal was arrested years after the FIR was filed in the case. So that is why the question was, the legal question was raised during the arguments also, and that is why the bench decided the matter to be referred to the larger bench. Section 19 and Section 45 have been categorically defined by this particular bench also, so that is why it is called a huge relief for Arvind Kejriwal, because the twin conditions of the PMLA, in which the bail is always a difficult task. Arvind Kejriwal gets an interim bail from the Supreme Court in this case, and he is already out on bail from the Rouse Avenue Court, and the High Court has stayed that. So on 17th, when the Delhi High Court will hear the matter on Arvind Kejriwal's stay, the lawyers from Arvind Kejriwal's team is going to mention about the Supreme Court's order into the case. But though he is already in the CBI custody, but he will not walk out of jail. But it's a huge relief for Arvind Kejriwal as far as the ED case is concerned, because he has challenged his arrest, but challenged the process of arrest, and the process of arrest is under the sub judice of now the of a larger bench, which the Supreme Court will constitute. This matter will now go to the Chief Justice. The Chief Justice will constitute a fresh constitution bench for framing these issues, and that is why it's also very importantly here, the Arvind Kejriwal is given a liberty whether to step down or not to step down. The court has said that it is his prerogative whether he wants to continue as a Chief Minister or not, because he is an elected member of the of Delhi, and that is why the bench said that we are leaving the question of being a Chief Minister or not to Arvind Kejriwal.
All right, he is going to decide whether he wants to continue or not. However, he suffered for 90 days for interrogation. Custody is not required. That's what the Supreme Court of India has said, granting interim bail to the Delhi Chief Minister today. However, he continues to be behind bars because he right now, in fact, is in the CBI custody.